Hello, and welcome to this Hurricane Electric presentation about IPv6 auto-configuration, understanding IPv6 router advertisements, and the router advertisement daemon. In this first example, we'll cover router advertisements on a router, and in this case, we'll be using a Foundry. RA is part of the neighbor discovery protocol, and by default is enabled on a router's interface. If you need to disable router advertisements or want to specify options, you can do this on the router's interface configuration using IPv6 ND. On this slide, we have an example output of what available options you can use to set with. If on this interface you had multiple /64 allocations and you only wanted to use one for hosts to auto-configure out of, you would use the prefix advertisement subcommand. So, as the example on this slide shows, in the interface's config, you do IPv6 ND prefix advertisement, the /64 you wish to announce, and then you set the valid lifetime and preferred lifetime. For an example of what this interface might look like with multiple allocations and using one of them for router advertisements, this slide has example output. Here we have 4/64s configured, and we've opted to use one of the ones in the middle to advertise with router advertisements. Continuing on to the router advertisement daemon and Linux, here you configure the first usable IPv6 address out of a /64 you wish to announce and configure it on the LAN-facing interface. So if you have a Linux machine with ETH0 and ETH1, and ETH0 is your WAN interface, or your internet uplink, and ETH1 is used for your LAN, connecting to the switch with all your other hosts connecting to that switch, you'd specify ETH1. Here we have output showing a basically empty configuration on ETH1. We then apply that first usable IPv6 address to the interface, and then we show what the interface looks like with that address configured. Next, you'll need to get the router advertisement daemon package installed. Once installed, you'll edit its configuration file. Depending on your Linux distribution, it can be in either /etc or /user/local/etc. You'll need to follow the documentation. In this case, we want to make sure it's configured for the LAN-facing NIC, so we specify interface ETH1. These are some of the basic options that are available. You can read more about different options under the RADVD documentation. You also specify in this config, underneath the interface, what prefix you want advertised. This needs to be the same prefix that you've configured that first usable address out of. After configuring RADVD, you'll need to make sure that Syskittle is configured to forward IPv6 packets. By default, all interfaces need to get the forwarding configured. So in syskittle.conf, you would set the following flag that we have as an example. Once you've configured the first usable address on your LAN-facing NIC, and you've configured the router advertising daemon's config file, and you've configured Syskittle to allow IPv6 packet forwarding, you can now start the RADVD daemon, and hosts on LAN should begin auto-configuring addresses out of that /64. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us at ipv6@he.net. Thank you.